Okay, hi everyone. So today let's discuss this interesting problem. So it says suppose the platform with the kid in the previous problem is rotating in anticlockwise direction at an angular speed omega. The kid starts walking along the rim with a speed v relative to the platform also in anticlockwise direction. Find the new angular speed of the platform. Fine. So jaise hume previous problem mein diya tha, is tarah se hamare paas platform hai, radius r and moment of inertia of the platform about its axis is I, right? And there is a kid of mass capital M standing on the rim of the platform. Initially this platform and the kid is rotating in anti-clockwise direction with angular velocity omega, right? So pehle hum apna system define kar lete hain. I am defining my system as this kid plus this platform. Now what happens ki ye jo kid hai ye walk karna start karta hai on the rim of this platform. So what will happen, you can see, jab bhi hum kisi surface pe walk karte hain, so friction force lagta hai. It means there will be friction force between this kid and the platform, but that force will be an internal force for the system. So ek internal torque aayega about the axis. So is there any external force acting on the system? No. So is there any external torque acting on the system? No. So we can say that because net external torque acting on the system is zero, we can conserve the angular momentum of the system. Pehle initial angular momentum ki agar hum baat kare, so dekho kitna hoga, I plus capital M into R square into omega. Yeah, that is moment of inertia. Is kid ka bhi aayega into angular velocity. Direction dekho, omega ke direction mein apne right hand ke fingers ko curve karo. So jo direction of thumb aa raha hai, that is in the upward direction, that is the direction of angular momentum. इस तरह से अपवर्ड. नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस कि जब ये किड वॉक करना स्टार्ट करता है, सो इसका रिलेटिव वेलोसिटी दे रखा है विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द प्लेटफॉर्म. पहले हम इस किड का लीनियर वेलोसिटी एज्यूम कर लेते हैं विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द ग्राउंड, दैट इज v1. और ये एंटी क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन में मूव करना स्टार्ट करता है, इट मींस जो वेलोसिटी होगी v1 दैट विल बी समथिंग लाइक दिस, राइट? ये रेडियस r है और ये जो एंगल होगा ये 90 डिग्री होगा, राइट? सो v1 क्या है? v1 इज द linear velocity of this kid with respect to the ground ke frame se, and friction force lagega. So uske karan kya hoga ki ye jo platform hai iska bhi angular velocity change ho jayega. Let's say iska angular velocity kya hai, kuch omega 1. So hamare paas kitne variable hai, v1 and omega 1. So hame do equation chahiye, right? So ek equation to simple hai, aap dekho, relative velocity of this kid is given with respect to the platform. Pehle ye dekho ki ये जो किड है जिस पॉइंट पे खड़ा है, लेट्स से दिस पॉइंट इज पी वेयर दिस किड इज स्टैंडिंग, व्हाट इज द लीनियर वेलोसिटी ऑफ दिस पॉइंट पी? दैट विल बी सिंपली ओमेगा 1 इनटू आर, राइट? ये रेडियस आर है और ये जो प्लेटफॉर्म है ये ओमेगा 1 से रोटेट कर रहा है. सो लीनियर वेलोसिटी ऑफ दिस पॉइंट पी विल बी ओमेगा 1 इनटू आर इन एंटी क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन. सो व्हाट इज द रिलेटिव वेलोसिटी ऑफ दिस किड विद रिस्पेक्ट टू दिस पॉइंट पी, है ना, विद रिस्पेक्ट टू प्लेटफॉर्म कह लो या फिर विद रिस्पेक्ट टू पॉइंट पी कह लो. That will be simply v1 minus omega 1 into r, dono hi anti-clockwise direction mein hai. So subtraction hoga, that is equal to v. Ek equation to ye aa gayi. Second equation, final angular momentum. Aap dekho, ye jo kid hai, iska angular momentum kitna hoga? Iska mass into iski velocity into r. Aur direction, r cross v, that is in the upward direction. Right? Angular momentum hum kaise nikalte? Linear momentum. R cross linear momentum m into v, so you can check, right? R cross v, that will be in the upward direction, and r or v ke beech mein angle 90 degree hai, so sin 90 aayega. Anyway, aur ye jo platform hai iska angular momentum hoga I into omega 1, iska bhi direction upar ki taraf aayega, right? So is tarah se now final angular momentum is m v1 r plus I into omega 1, that is initial angular momentum, I plus mr square into omega, I plus mr square into omega. So हमें omega 1 का value find out करना है, so एक काम करो, यहाँ से v1 का value निकालो. v1 का value कितना आएगा? v1 will be simply v plus omega 1 into r, और ये v1 का value उठा के यहाँ put कर दो. So देखो, m into r into v plus omega 1 into r plus I into omega 1, that is I plus mr square into omega. सो यहाँ से ओमेगा 1 का वैल्यू निकाल लो, I प्लस एम आर स्क्वायर इंटू ओमेगा एंड माइनस एम इंटू आर इंटू वी डिवाइडेड बाय I plus mr square. So I think you have understood. Let me know if you still have any confusion. We can discuss further. Okay guys, keep working hard. Best of luck. Bye.